me.
When I make a movie, is it a story I want to tell? And would I want to go watch this film? And if those two things come together, then I'll direct it.
I think audiences will be surprised by the breadth and scope of this Kingsman film. They'll certainly be surprised by it being so committed to a historical era with historical figures in it. I think they'll be surprised by the tonal shifts that Matthew is daring himself to bring off, from First World War horror and tragedy to Kingsman joie de vivre and swashbuckling humour and mischief.
It's a bit of everything, you know. There's a bit of like Oscar-worthy acting from Rafe, and there's a bit of incredible chase scene, and then probably, you know, you'll be laughing your ass off at another point. All under this sort of guise of how the war was started. It's very clever.
That's Matthew's thing, is always surprise your audience. Looking at history through this kind of, you know, anarchic, mischievous prism is challenging, you know, and I think it's very refreshing. Done right, and I think it's being done right.
It's weighted in a very real human story. It's possibly, it's got its fantastical side to it, but it's rooted in real stuff that happened.
I think in this film, more than the other two Kingsmen, there's real loss, real heart-wrenching events that will echo in us all, I think.
The whole point of this is to go back in time to set up the franchise, set up the what we know is the relationship between Taryn and Colin for movies going forward.
A tailor shop?
Yes, sir. Number 11, Savile Row.
It's centered around Kingsman World Finest Tailor. There's a sort of gentleman-like quality to the backbone of the film. But also, Matthew doesn't stick to anything preset, and this film doesn't necessarily follow guidelines of a Kingsman film. I do think Matthew has tried to make something a little different.
One of the things that Matthew assured me, I guess when he was trying to snag me for the role, was he said he's always wanted to make a female Bond film. And I thought, me too. So, you know, it suggested that Polly takes on a much more important role in the Kingsman tribe. So I look forward to seeing a bit more, you know. Especially because, you know, some of the other characters are a bit older and less agile, maybe. We shall see.
It would even give you a chance to then make a sequel of the prequel, which I'm hoping for, because that would give me a chance to come back for no good. Because then, if you think about it, the way the film ends is actually a perfect opener for the next chapter in history, you know, having Lenin and having Hitler and me. I'll have to talk to Matthew.
I think it's going to be a rather good movie, actually. Mind you, having said that, we're all having quite a lot of fun. It can be a bit dangerous sometimes. But, you know, Matthew's running the show pretty well.
Kingsman, it's an epic adventure that will make you laugh, that will make you cry, it will take you on a journey that you're not expecting. You'll also learn a lot about history. And you'll see the foundations of, you know, an independent intelligence agency above the bureaucratic rules of government run spy agencies. If you were a Kingsman fan, this will confirm why you are. And if you're not a Kingsman fan, hopefully this might convert you.